Hey everyone, and welcome back. This is Marine, and today we join our cute mice family again. And we join them in a very special occasion. Kelly and Mike, the owners of Lanfan, just had a baby boy. And to help in the house, those cute mice have offered to take care of the laundry. Like always, I used several stamp sets to create my card, and I first started by stamping all the images on Nina Solar White cardstock using jet black ink, and you will find all the supplies listed below the video. And by the way, I already have some ideas for future cards featuring this cute mice family, but I'm open to suggestions. When the coloring was done, I cut a reveal wheel panel out of Strathmore Gristle cardstock. And to create the interactive part, I needed to cut a window out of this panel, but not at the top, like it's usually done. I wanted the window to be lower. So I placed the so-called window die on the notch with the cutting side on top to be able to see the shape of it. I put the circle template on top and stuck it to the panel using washi tape. I carefully removed the circle window die and placed it on the bottom circle of the template, with this time the cutting side facing down. I taped the die and removed the template, as well as the panel die, and I sent the paper to my die cutting machine. Once my window was cut out, I started creating the sky, a simple sky using the cloudy stencil along with tumble glass distress ink. I turned the stencil for each line to get a good variation in the clouds, and I worked my way towards the bottom of the panel. Like always, I added a little bit of texture to the clouds. I mixed salty ocean distress ink with water on my glass surface and splattered tiny drops on the paper using a very thin brush. And I felt that it needed something else, so I added some drops of liquid stardust all over the panel. It's barely visible right now, but when you look at the card at a certain angle, it makes the sky sparkle a lot. When my sky was dry, I cut the wheel and stuck it to my work surface. Next, I placed my panel on top and lined it up with the score lines on the side of the wheel. I placed my stencil on top of the panel and made sure that the clouds were coordinated. I removed the panel and kept the stencil in place and used tumble glass distress ink again to create clouds on the wheel. This way, when the wheel will be behind the panel, everything will be coordinated. End of screen, I repeated that same process to get coordinating clouds on another piece of reveal wheel panel. Next, I die cut a small circle and put a small brad through the little hole in the middle. And I put this brad at the back of the wheel through the hole as well. I opened the brad to keep the pieces together and I applied foam squares around the brad on the circle. So here are my elements. I removed the backing paper of the foam squares and placed the wheel behind the panel, making sure to line up the clouds. And I pressed down onto the second panel to stick the wheel only. And before attaching the panel to the wheel element, I stamped my sentiment, "Welcome baby boy," at the top using jet black ink. I applied foam tape around the wheel, making sure not to touch it, removed the backing paper, and attached the panel on top. To ground my scene, I cut a grass border that I colored using shabby shutters and modeled distress inks. Shabby shutters all over the border and a little bit of modeled at the top to bring contrast. And of course, I added texture to that border using the same inks mixed with water. Next, I attached the border at the bottom of my panel. I applied foam tape and double-sided tape at the back of my panel and attached it on the 5.5 by 4.25 inches rainbow panel. Next, I started to attach the images, starting with this one. I just couldn't stick it this way, so I decided to cut it in 3 pieces according to the shape of the panel. So I glued the middle piece in the background on the second cloud panel. And I attached the 2 other pieces at the top and bottom, but this time on the front panel. This way, the image was still a whole element, but without interfering in the wheel mechanism. And next, I kept going and attached the remaining images using, like always, a combination of liquid glue, foam squares, and glue dots. When everything was attached, I stamped tiny arrows directly on the wheel so the recipient of the card knows what to do. I also stamped a heart on the baby bodysuit and added white highlights on the images as well. Finally, I applied some white Blizzard Nouveau drops on the butterflies and added a few Morning Dew drops here and there to bring an extra touch of shine. And that's it, all done. Those mice seem to be pretty busy. One more time, congratulations Kelly and Mike, and welcome to the world, Baby Miles. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you very soon, maybe for another adventure of this mice family. Bye guys!